Today, we are going to convert the studio lighting and cycles project we created first into Blender 2.80 EEVEE engine. Blender 2.80 EEVEE engine is a real-time engine, and it has some differences when compared with cycles engine. First, open the studio lighting project we created earlier. After opening, copy all objects in its viewport and close the Blender. Now run into Blender 2.80. After running into Blender, delete all objects in its viewport and paste the objects we copied into this Blender. After pasting the objects, turn Blender's viewport into rendering. Now you can see that the viewport is rendering, but EEVEE engine is not lighting properly like cycles. Blender's cycles engine use emission shader for its lights, but EEVEE engine only use light data for it. If you open your cycles projects in Blender's EEVEE engine, first, EEVEE engine checks whether all lights contain light data or not. If lights don't have any light data, then EEVEE engine gives default light data for all lights. This is the reason for the lighting issue. Therefore, we have to fix this issue. As a next step, turn your viewport into camera view, and split your viewport into two parts. After splitting, turn left side viewport into shader editor. Now go to your outliner and click collection drop down, and then select first area light. After selection the area light, you can observe shader editor shows emission node for this light. You know that EEVEE light only use light data for its lighting process. Therefore, we have to convert this emission into EEVEE light data, and keep in consideration that emission shader contains two values, namely strength and color values. Now click lights data tab, and simply drag and drop emission node's color value into light data's color value. Now you can observe that emission shader have strength value, but light data tab contain energy value for that. Therefore, we have to convert the strength value into energy value. Emission strength and light data's energy values converting method depend on a variety of lights. In this scene, we only use area lights, therefore copy emission's strength value into light data's energy value, and divide that value by 100. You can do this converting method for all your area lights. Now select the other area lights and do the same procedure we have done for the first area light. After converting all lights, close the shader editor. Now we have converted all lights into EEVEE engine. If you want to know more about converting cycles lighting into EEVEE engine, then go to ibnblender3dartworks.blogspot.com logs converting cycles lighting into EEVEE article and learn more. You can get this link from video description shown below. After that, you can see our all area lights are casting hardest shadow for the scene. You know that the project we created in cycles engine casted soft shadow for our studio lights, but EEVEE engine is totally opposite, because cycles engine casts softness of the shadow for its scenes depending on the distance between the object and the light and size of the light. But we have to fix this shadow's softness manually in EEVEE engine. First, go to your lights data tab and click shadow drop down. You can see an option called softness value, and set its value into 20. Now do the same for your all area lights. After setting, you can see that softest shadow is casting for all area lights. Now all our area lights are lighting properly. We have to enable some of the EEVEE features to get more result for this scene. First, change your viewport into camera view. After changing it, go to your render tab and enable screen space reflection and ambient occasion features. Now you can see that the objects are reflecting and have some ambient occasion between two objects. We need more ambient occasion for this scene, therefore, Click Ambient Occasion drop-down, and set its distance value into 0.5. Moreover, Blender EEVEE Engine doesn't cast indirect lights to the scene without light probe. Therefore, we have to add light probe to this scene. In order to it, turn your viewport into solid and front orthographic view, and then add light probe zeradiance volume to your viewport. After adding, scale that probe 9 times and adjust it slightly to cover all lights and base. Now we are to bake indirect lights into this light probe. First, turn viewport into camera view and set into rendering, and then hide all area lights. Hiding all lights is not important for baking lights. If you hide these lights, then you can watch how indirect lights are baking to this scene. Now go to Render tab, and click Indirect Lighting drop down, and then click Bake Indirect Lighting. After clicking, you can see indirect lights are baking in your scene. After that, if you have hid your lights, then unhide them. Now you can see studio lighting is perfect. We have to enable one more feature for this scene. Go to Render tab, and enable Bloom feature and click that drop down, and set its intensity into 0.3. Now you can see that your scene is blooming. Now our studio is ready to render. Hit following key to render this scene. You can do more things using this lighting. Simply replace the demo object in this with your 3D model, and render it. Moreover, you can render any type of objects using this studio, like metallic or non-metallic objects, reflective or non-reflective objects, and also glasses can be rendered. We are always looking for your comments. You can comment your questions, ideas and more. You can also comment for what videos you want next. The comment which gets more likes expecting for a new video, will be the next video lesson of this channel. If you like this video, hit like button. If you have learned something new, hit subscribe. If you hit the bell icon, you will get notifications as soon as we upload a new video. Learn with IBN. Thank you for watching.